It's daybreak in Mondulkiri in the eastern province of Cambodia. The Benong community is one of the many indigenous groups living in this region. For generations, subsistence farming has been the way of life the Benong and other communities have known. Krosok is a Benong community leader. But long gone are those days when the community enjoyed living a simple life on large and scarcely populated tracts of land. Well-intentioned efforts to open up the region for development have meant that the indigenous communities have to forgo century-old customs, such as land ownership. Many here now live with a constant fear of losing their ancestral land, as development projects such as construction of roads and extraction of natural resources take centre stage. Communal land is also rapidly being acquired by outsiders for speculative purposes. But Sok and his community are not opposed to development. What they want is their voice to be heard in the development agenda and to be able to preserve their land rights, to which their culture and identity is bound. The government of Cambodia is encouraging communities to formalise their land ownership through a land registration programme. The land registration process can be long and complicated. But with the support of the UN Human Rights Office and other development partners, the indigenous people's right to own land is being recognised. According to the International Labour Organization's office in Cambodia, more than 40 indigenous communities have been registered as legal entities so far. 4,000 people have received communal land titles from the government.
The ILO ensures meaningful participation of indigenous people in decision making in the whole process, and also ensure the actors, including government agency and the civil society, to enable indigenous community to claim land and natural resources that they are possessing so far.
The Universal Declaration of Human Rights proclaims that everyone has the right to own property alone as well as in association with others. Like Sok, quenching his thirst, other indigenous communities can freely exercise their right to own property through a transparent and accountable process. And as the world's boundaries continue to expand, for local communities like Sok's, protecting their land rights and ensuring their voice in development is heard and respected is their priority.